Hi everyone,
it's Heather Darnell and welcome back to my art channel. So Halloween is right around the corner, and that said, a lot of us are thinking, what am I going to be this year? How am I going to dress up and innocently be deceptive, so to speak, for the night and just have fun? Which all is fine and well, but really, we don't live in a world that's only deceptive on an innocent level for one night out of the whole year. We live in a world that's deceptive constantly, 24/7, 365. We are constantly being deceived on a number of levels in a lot of different ways. So that's what really inspired me to do this piece for today. Although it is Halloween themed related, I really just wanted to set the tone of what we live in. And the ministry snack I wanted to share with you is actually the verse I'm gonna put on this piece, which comes from the book of James, chapter 1, verse 16. And it reads, "Do not be deceived." Well, that's all she wrote. Super short and sweet and to the point. Actually, that's one of the most short, most direct biblical verses that's in the Bible. Do not be deceived. It's pretty powerful when you think about it. And it's so hard to realize how hard it is to not be deceived, because the world is so full of deception. And we, myself included, are just as guilty of that deception. So I just feel like I have a lot on my heart that I want to share with you. And so I think I'm going to share that for the end result. So that way, what I have on my mind and in my heart kind of sits with you better by looking at the end result of this picture. So let's get started. I'm beginning my project lightly sketching in the apple, which I know was kind of hard to see. And so I apologize for that, but I'm putting the apple slightly off center to the right, a little bit higher than the center line and a little bigger than my fist. Next is the thumb, which the tip is around the midsection and is pointing at about a 45 degree angle, yet the inside of the thumb goes straight down. The index finger also goes up and out at about 45 degree angles as well, and comes out about an inch or so higher than the apple. Notice the finger has bumps as the knuckles and are about a couple of inches apart. The last or middle finger is about an inch or so apart as well from the index finger, and take note that the apple should cover about half of that finger. The nails are about an inch long and of course come to a point at the ends. Lastly, the stem is in the middle and curves around to the right. When I'm satisfied with my sketch, I draw in the lines darker so they'll stand out more when I paint. For the background, I'm using my go-to 1-inch tip flat brush or wash brush with the color Mars Black that I have mixed in with some GAC 500, which stands for Golden Artist Colors. That is an artist-grade gloss extender for acrylic paints so that my paints will go a little farther. This is an opaque color, so thankfully I don't need a second coat. After I fill in the background, I switch brushes to my number 8 flat shader using napthol crimson to fill in the apple. This too is an opaque color, but I'm going to need a few coats to get that really bright red color. The con to working with a white background is that colors may appear lighter, therefore needing more coats. Just as it's the same working on a black background, you may need more coats than you realize because the initial coat may seem dark and or dull. After a few coats of the napthol crimson, I spend a few minutes here creating shadowing by adding a little bit of Mars Black mixed with the napthol crimson. This can be more time consuming for some or less time consuming for others. It really just depends on the skill level of the artist and how they get it to their liking.
But if you're a beginner, don't let shadowing make you feel like it's too hard to even bother. Everyone starts somewhere, and painting shouldn't be done in a hurry anyway. Just take note that the majority of the shadowing is toward the bottom of the apple. Notice I do a lot of up and down brush strokes as well as contouring the apple to make the apple look nice and smooth. After I get the shadowing to my liking, I add in an iridescent paint, which is just a specialty paint called Fiery Red, which looks pink and is semi-transparent to add some reflecting details, but I don't fully cover the apple. For this paint to actually look red, you'd need to apply at least 4 to 5 coats, but that's not what I'm gonna do here. I also briefly go back and add some more napthol crimson and Mars black, just because I'm kind of playing around here still between the different paints. Lastly, I add a little bit of titanium white at the top for some highlights. For the hand, I do a base coat of a 50-50 mix of titanium white and neutral gray number 5, still using my number 8 flat shader brush. This portion, you won't see me completing all the shadowing and details because my phone gave me a low battery warning, so I decided to charge it as soon as I could, so I apologize for that as well. But the shadowing mixture is neutral gray number 5 and a tidbit of Mars black, which is highly concentrated on the back finger, a small portion of the index finger, and between the thumb at the base, the thumb itself, and the center of the wrist and the forearm. Make sure to leave a thin line of the base coat showing on the index finger for highlights. Onto the fog and flames. I haven't changed brushes, but I have changed colors, obviously. So here I'm using light green permanent, which is another opaque color. Now here's a perfect example of using a bright color on a black background. The first coat or layer is pretty dull, as you can see, which in this instance is perfect. I don't want a flat, bright green color right off the bat. I want it sort of foggy looking so I can work on it from there. after I've done my go around, I add a little more color and shape to the edges, as well as using the chisel edge of my brush, going in a wavy motion to create the flames. You'll see the more detail that I add, the more it stands out because more layers are being applied, so it helps give it that 3D look. Here I'm adding another iridescent paint called Shocking Lime Green so that it will add more reflection within the ball of flames. Now I'm using the back end of my brush, still using the same color, but just stamping in various sized dots in and around the flames to help give it that magical or enchanted type look and feel. For the nails, I use a base coat of Mars Black, still using my handy dandy number 8 flat shader brush, and then switch to my number 8 round brush to get into those tighter areas. I top off the nail color here with yet another iridescent paint called Fancy Black. I swear, some of these name colors are hilarious. Anyway, still using my number 8 round brush and then following a little bit of titanium white along the edge for highlights. The stem here is super simple. Just fill it in with raw umber and then a smidget of titanium white at the top portion for highlights. Now I switch to my small detail brush to outline the inside of the hand, a portion of the fingers, as well as the apple. Thank you. check out these details. I swear, these iridescent paints can also be deceptive. Think about it. It looks one color, but then when the light hits it, it's another. So let me continue on the topic of deception here for a couple of quick minutes, or, well, I hope it's quick because it is no joke. We are constantly fixated on what is pleasing to the eyes and our ears, and most of the time we just take what we are soaking in and call it gospel without doing any homework, down to the food we eat. Not to mention we put all our eggs in the basket trusting that what we have been seeing and hearing is the best of the best for us, when in reality, it's a hot mess in disguise, and more often than not, it's a plan for destruction that sadly isn't even noticeable, nor do we realize it's a slow kill. Not just to our self-confidence making us feel guilty that we're not perfect, as no one is, as others act and appear to be with their filtered and Photoshopped pictures plastered all over social media. But believe it or not, deception is not just from others. It's also by our own hearts that collectively is a slow kill to our future, our health, and more importantly, our souls. People are flawed, whereas God is not. Once upon a time, and many of you may be familiar with the story, but for those who are not, in the beginning, God walked with his crowning achievement of creation, Earth's first people, Adam and Eve. Life and everything was perfect, the way he designed it to be. Sin had not existed, yet Satan did, and still does. God provided everything Adam and Eve could ever dream of in the Garden of Eden, and they were beyond thrilled and happy to be alive and have all their blessings. God loved them so much, as he does with us, that he also gave them the ability to choose for themselves, as we have the same freedom in modern times. They were not forced to follow his rules or even to love him back, just as we are not forced. But for those who do want to follow him and love him back, that is why we have the Bible, which technically isn't a rule book, it's a love letter. It's the story of God's love for his people, which is us, so that we can always be connected with him as a gesture of our faith and reciprocating love to him on earth, trusting that we are always protected and provided for as long as we want him in our hearts and our lives, just like Adam and Eve were protected and provided for. But Satan had another plan. He wanted to break their relationship with God, as he does with us, and wanted to get them to focus on the one thing they were told they couldn't have, and for good reason. Because God knew Satan would deceive his newly created people, therefore the warning. Kind of like when we tell our kids, don't talk to strangers. We know they tell kids things they want to hear. They're deceiving, and then boom, the unimaginable happens. Adam and Eve didn't even care about that stupid fruit tree. That's why they never even approached it. Even after they were told it's forbidden, it wasn't interesting enough to care about. They were seriously happy and focused on all that they already had because it was all good stuff and more than enough. But Satan had to get their attention somehow to get them to even come close to it, because he knew by their happiness and by being content, they weren't going to do anything wrong unless being prompted to be deceived. So it was up to him to do something about it, and so he did. His agenda of deception clearly worked on them, just as his simple tactics work as effectively on us today. He gets us to focus on all the things we don't need, distracting us from all that we have already been blessed with, and deceives us, making us think that all we focus on is more important than God and the fate of our souls. He gets so many of us deceived to the point where there's so many people out there who have never even heard of God, and that's the way he wants it. Or if they have heard of him, that he's a myth, and if there is a hell, well, it must be party central. You guys want to know what hell is like? God tells you. He's the one who made it, which, by the way, wasn't even made for us. It was made for Satan and his fallen angels. And anyone who goes there is by their own choice of rejecting God. So it was and never will be a case of God rejecting us. But look up the Gospel of Matthew 25:41 for that proof. Then for starters, the Gospel of Matthew that continues to mention what hell is like. So does the Book of Thessalonians, Revelations, the Book of Jude, Peter, the Gospel of Mark, and on I can go. So don't say you weren't warned. It's there, and if anyone purposely doesn't read the Bible, it's probably because they're afraid of the truth, knowing that the Bible actually reads us and calls us out on our junk, yet also not realizing it's our beacon of forever love and hope. So from there on out, we have lived in sin, yet God still wanted and wants to be our leader and guide, even with all of our continuous failures and shortcomings being 0% perfect, yet 100% forgiven. He's offering us his non-deceptive protection and perfection on every level, from peace, fairness, happiness, comfort, and loyalty, to name a few. Yet according to the book of Judges, even right after God rescued his people from centuries of hardcore slavery, his people still wanted an earthly king over a non-deceptive, all-knowing, and all-powerful heavenly king because it sounded better. You'd think since all they knew was the opposite and living in such awful conditions that it would be a total no-brainer. But they still made the choice and chose a human with human error to rule over them. He warned them of the deception they would encounter with a human as their overseer, which is, again, flawed and corrupt by the influence of the enemy. That they basically will be told one thing, yet another will happen. They will see one thing, yet they won't see the other. They will be told they are cared for when they will be oppressed. What they earn will be told it's going for a good cause when it will be going to the greed of the overseer. That they can have families, but the families will be separated and sold. That there will be no violence, yet wars will break out with mass deaths. You know what? The people later learned that he was right and prayed to him, crying for his help, and in no time, by his mercy, he sent in a judge to help. Until they grew tired of the help and foolishly wanted to live in the same deceptive and oppressive ways again mandated by an unloving ruler. This was such an ongoing vicious cycle and why that part or the book in the Bible is called Judges. You think they would have learned their lesson, and that goes for us today. You think we would have learned by now that Jesus is king and want his sovereignty, but no. Well, at least not everyone. And so we are left living in the declining state not only our beloved nation is going in, but our world too. We are literally handing it over to people who only care about themselves, who offer us a poisonous apple in return. So don't forget about the power of prayer, because although God raises kings and rulers up, he also brings them down. So if you feel weary and are worried, turn to our true ruler and king and never cease praying. He can make anything happen with prayer. Don't let the enemy deceive you and make you believe that there is no value in it, because prayer is the most effective weapon on Satan and he knows it. Therefore, doesn't want us to do it and keeps us distracted and deceived to make sure that we don't do it. Our God is not the author of confusion and deception, unlike Satan. God keeps his promises, whereas humans do not, or at least cannot, even when we have good intentions. Therefore, we are led to believe that a flawed person or a group of flawed people and their ways are the best to implement into our lives. And unfortunately, the media is another tool to get us to turn against each other, all by controlling the information we are allowed to see and not see, hear and not hear, know and not know. All which is ultimately deceiving us on so many levels and shortchanging us on our ability to see things through God's eyes and his perspective. He is our ticket to an earthly life without the deception that is slowly killing us. People have a natural desire to say and do things to benefit their purpose and agenda, not caring how it affects the lives of others. And sadly, we are becoming a bunch of sheeple as we are also witnessing the fading of our Savior, not even giving him the chance to prove his mighty wonders, again, simply because of the deception of those who don't want to believe in him. Therefore, they don't want us to either, or at least make us believe that he is not good for us. I can't emphasize enough that the enemy deceives us and makes us believe instead that God is a liar, self-righteous, unfair, unloving, provoking, and or a hypocrite, all so that we follow the ways of the world and not the ways of the Holy Spirit. But by wholeheartedly believing in and following Christ, suddenly you will be given his ears to hear, his eyes to see, and his knowledge to know what smells like garbage and what smells like lilies. His truth literally sets us free. An accurate quote from Daily BB Motivation hits the nail on the head as it says, and I quote, "The Bible is not just for motivational purposes and cute quotes. It's the transforming, life-changing, curse-breaking, soul-refreshing, flesh-cutting word of God," end quote. Wow. But regarding your relationship with Christ, like my sister in Christ from Bible study says, you're either in or you're out, you're either hot or you're cold, you're either black or white. There are no gray areas, warm spells, or being on the fence, because if that's the case, you will never witness and experience the miracle of change and power that he and only he alone gives us. So let me reiterate that what looks perfect, enticing, juicy, and fulfilling like this apple here is not always what it seems. People can produce toxic and poisonous fruits with their deception unto others that only appears to be as wonderful as those who make a valiant effort to produce righteous fruit that is produced by the Holy Spirit that lives within the hearts of those who welcome and honor him. So remember that Satan wants you to doubt God, hate him, or not even know his name. He wants your fate to be the same as his, so don't go down with the sinking ship. Satan wouldn't be attacking us so hard with all of this deception and then some if there wasn't something so valuable inside of us. Thieves don't break into empty houses, period. Wow. Okay, yeah, that was a little more than a couple of minutes. And if you stuck it out this long, all I have to say is bless you and thank you so much for your time. I hope this piece lets reality sink in of the spiritual world and battles we endure. Anyway, this concludes this demo, and just a heads up, this is my last video in my transitional home here. We are finally on our way to our next duty station in California. So between the cross-country road trip and unpacking of 6,232 boxes, it may be a few weeks or so to post another video. So thank you in advance for your understanding and your patience. But if you liked this tutorial and or my whole spiel of my own two cents about deception, please be sure to not only share this, but to also hit like and subscribe for more videos. But more importantly, remember to thank God for this opportunity and always paint from the soul.